A very good morning to all of you. This is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can create this pipe animation in PowerPoint 2016. And the important thing about this animation is that how you can hide these oval inside these pipe, and you can call it masking in PowerPoint 2016. And on the second slide we have the same animation, but this time all the ovals are changing their color when they move up and down. So this animation is inspired from one of the animation by Adam Kuhn at codepen.io website, and I tried to replicate the same in PowerPoint 2016, and I hope you will like this. So let's get started, and I have another presentation here with predefined color palette on the top. And first of all I will go to the insert tab, click the shapes drop down button and draw a cylinder here, and just click inside the presentation to draw a default size cylinder, and then adjust the size of this cylinder. Zoom in a little bit by holding the control key and then use middle mouse button to zoom in and zoom out. Now adjust the face of this pipe by holding this yellow handler and drag it down just like that. Now the next thing is to draw an oval, and for that go to insert shapes and take an oval and just click inside the slide, hold down the control alt and shift keys and then just reduce the size. Now place this oval on the top of this pipe here and then adjust the size. It should not be smaller than the face of the pipe, so you should take care of that, especially on the top. You can hold down the alt key to make it a bit larger according to the mouse movement. When you hold down the alt key and move or resize the objects, then it totally increase or decrease the size according to your mouse movements. So I will drag it right here. I will make a copy of this oval by selecting this oval and pressing Ctrl D, and will place it right here. We will use it later on. So the next thing is to select this pipe first, hold on the shift key and then select this oval on the top, and on the format tab click merge shapes drop down button and choose subtract, and it should look like this. Now place this oval on the top of the face of the pipe. So both of these objects will make a single pipe, and why I am doing this I will show you later on. And you must remember that you have to send this pipe face to the back of all the objects, and for that from the format tab click send backward drop down menu and choose send to back. Now I will choose the colors, and for that I will choose shape fill white color and outline color black, and same for the body of the pipe. So we have one pipe ready here, and next we will draw another oval that will move inside the pipe and will reduce the size and then place it in the middle of this pipe. Now I will choose shape fill, will take eyedropper and will choose this color for the first oval and will remove the outline. Now the next thing is to replicate these three objects 9 times, and for that select all these three objects, hold down the control shift key and then just drag it like that. Once you have copied the three objects using this method, now what you can do next is press the F4 key to repeat the same command, and I will use this 9 times, 3, 3, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Now select all of these objects, go to format, group, and make a group of all of these objects and align them to center and middle of the slide, and then ungroup them. So if you select one of these oval and drag it to down, then you can see that it is on the top of the 5. So what you have to do, select all of the 5 bodies and take them on the top, bring to front from the format tab. Now if you move this oval here to the down, then it will hide behind this pipe. So this is the technique that we are using to make a masking here and to hide these oval behind the pipe. So the next thing I will do is to change the fill color of all these oval, and for that I will use the eyedropper from the shape fill drop down button and will change the color of all of these 9 ovals. Now select all of these ovals holding the shift key and then drag them to the middle of these pipes right here. Now the first animation that we will apply will be motion path, and that will be up motion path. And for that, go to the animations tab, click add animation drop down button and choose more motion path, and here I will choose up motion path. Hit the OK key. The path is a bit larger, so what I will do, I will adjust the path of these, all of these 9 ovals here. Open the animation pan and here I will adjust the path length, or I will delete all of these animation first on the top and select one. Here is another problem in PowerPoint. If you select all of these animation from the animation pan by holding the shift key and then try to reduce the size, then again it will only adjust the path length of one oval here. That is a problem in PowerPoint, whereas it should reduce the size of all the ovals simultaneously because all of the animations are selected. But PowerPoint never do that. So what you have to do, you have to do it manually to each oval. To make the accuracy, what you can do, you can turn on the guides from the view tab by making a check mark on guides and then adjust this horizontal guide right here. And when you will adjust the path of the second oval, then it will move just like that properly over the guides. Just like that. Now select the first animation, hold on the shift key and select the last one. Go to the animation tab and set the duration to 1 second and set all of them to play with previous. Open the effect option window by right clicking on one of the effect and go to effect options, and here make a check mark on auto reverse. Go to the timing tab and set it to repeat until end of the slide. Hit the OK key. So the next thing is to add a delay timing between all of these effects, and I will use a delay timing of 0.05 for the second, 0.10 for the third, and so on. I am adding a 0.05 delay between each oval. And finally 0.40 for the last one. Let's see the slideshow first. So if you want to apply any other animation on these ovals, you can do it right away. So the next thing I will do is to select all of these effects again by selecting the top one and holding the shift key and then select the last one. That way it will select the oval behind these pipes. And now go to the animations tab, click add animation drop down button and apply the fill color. Set it to play with previous. Set the delay timing to 0 and set the duration to, I will apply 3 second duration. Open the effect option window and here choose the colors you want, and I will also apply auto reverse and will repeat this effect until end of the slide. So it is up to you if you want, if you also want to add a delay timing between these effects, or you can make them just like that without any delay timing. So let's see the slideshow once. and you can see that all of these ovals are changing their color when they move up and down. So the last thing here is, I will adjust this guy right here. So the last thing is to replicate all of these objects, and for that select all of them and make a duplicate by holding the Ctrl Shift key and just drag them to the bottom. And I will delete one of these and will now place all of them just like that. Now again make a duplicate of all of these 8 objects, delete one of them, select all of these 7 and then adjust them like that. Again make duplicate, delete the last one, select all of them and then place them just like that. And finally the last one for the bottom, delete one of them and place them just like that. So the bottom part is ready, and let me show you the slideshow. So this is how you can create this animation, and you can make as many replications you want for these pipe and ovals. And I hope you will like this animation. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below, and don't forget to hit the like button and do share this video with your friends. And you can also subscribe to my channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.